Please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is
Reprise
now back in
l'audience.
Session. And again, the floor will be given to Nunchia to make his final statement.
À Nunchia.
You may now continue.
Je vous en prie.
Nunchia. The issue of evacuation.
J'en viens à la question de l'évacuation.
As I have testified before the chamber during the last couple of years,
cette chambre, ces deux
after the liberation
années,
on 17 April 1975,
après la libération du 17 avril 1975,
all city dwellers
tous les
were indeed evacuated out of the cities. However,
Mais
it was not a forced evacuation.
Cela n'a pas été une évacuation forcée.
There were two main reasons that leaders decided to rely upon in so doing.
Une telle décision pour deux grandes raisons.
First,
premièrement,
it was the fear of American bombardment.
Des bombardements américains.
On the cities after the Lunar government
contre les
was
villes
defeated.
Après la défaite du gouvernement de Lon Nol.
And this was one reason
C'était
that the leadership and Cambodian people believed.
À laquelle croyaient
they
les dirigeants et le peuple cambodgien.
The United States
l'on
would renew
que les États-Unis
its bombardment
reprendraient
in many cities,
leur bombardement
and
contre
especially
de nombreuses
in
villes
Phnom Penh.
Et en particulier contre Phnom Penh.
They believed that because the United States had previously dropped several tons of bombs in Cambodia.
Les États-Unis avaient largué
the second reason was that war had been waged in Cambodia for over 5 years.
La deuxième raison, c'était la guerre.
Through this experience of war, Cambodia faced many challenges.
Avait été mené
including
au Cambodge
food shortage.
Pendant cette période de guerre,
and food shortage was a main problem
le Cambodge a connu
that
de
needed
nombreux
to be resolved urgently,
c'était là un
as
problème
it was related
à
to the life of
d'urgence,
people.
Car c'était lié aux conditions de vie
at that time,
de la population.
Cambodia did not receive any foreign aid or
le
assistance.
Cambodge n'a reçu aucune aide étrangère.
Facing such pressing circumstances, the CPK leadership devised a plan to evacuate people to regions and provinces where they were rich in economic resources, task and unhasked rights, that could feed the evacuated people. In turn, they would be required to join in the production activity for self-sufficiency and country reconstruction.
Permettant de nourrir
in relation to evacuating people from Phnom Penh City,
en contrepartie,
the Standing Committee instructed the Central Committee to convene a meeting to prepare for evacuation.
L'autosuffisance et la reconstruction. Concernant l'évacuation de Phnom Penh,
all members of the Central Committee attended that meeting, and I recall that
au comité central,
the Northwest Zone agreed to receive 1.5 million evacuees.
Je me souviens que la zone
the East,
a
the Southwest, and the Central Zones agreed
est,
to take the rest of the evacuees.
D'accueillir le reste des évacués.
For the plan implementation, each zone had the autonomy to coordinate amongst themselves to facilitate the evacuation. They had to provide instructions to cooperatives to assist the evacuees from Phnom Penh.
Les zones devaient donner instruction aux coopératives
without any discrimination against them.
Sans aucune discrimination.
With the two reasons,
compte tenu de ces deux
the evacuation proceeded on a voluntary basis, without coercion,
sans coercition,
violence,
sans violence,
or any killing,
et sans aucune exécution.
It was implemented via clear information being explained to the people.
De la diffusion
to understand the risk of being bombarded by the United States on cities and the need to resolve the living condition of the people and self-construction of the country.
Il a été expliqué qu'il fallait
at that time, people understood the dangerous situation and the pressing need for the country.
À l'époque,
especially people supported and loved the revolution.
Ils ont compris qu'il était
gradually,
urgent
people left the cities in accordance with the
ainsi,
explanation and appealed by the CPK.
D'autant plus que les gens soutenaient et aimaient la révolution. Peu à peu, les gens ont quitté les villes.
Regarding this point,
aux explications
I would like to respond to
PCK.
The co-prosecutor's argument.
À cet égard, j'aimerais répondre à l'argument de l'accusation.
They allege that
les co-procureurs
the CPK surrounded Phnom Penh City
que le PCK
and that
a
led to food shortage.
Phnom Penh et que cela a provoqué
they
des
also allege that
l'accusation
shelling Lon Nol's military bases in the city
qu'il était
was an inhumane act.
De pilonner les bases militaires de Lon Nol établies en ville.
However, the co-prosecutors failed
l'accusation
to mention that
ne dit
Lon Nol soldiers
toutefois
equipped with artillery provided by the United States emptied many millions of shells and together with more than half a million tons of bombs dropped by the United States, they devastated the country as houses, properties, animals and farms were destroyed.
Larguer des millions de
especially tens of thousands of people were killed,
ainsi,
including the elderly, children and women.
Tonnes de bombes.
Isn't this an inhumane act or a crime?
Largué par les États-Unis, dévastant
the
le
bombs
pays,
that the United States dropped on
des maisons,
Cambodia
des biens, des animaux, des fermes,
were three times
des
more than those
personnes,
dropped
parmi lesquelles
on Japan
des personnes âgées, des femmes et des enfants.
During the Second
N'est-ce pas là
World
un crime
War.
Ou un acte inhumain? Les Américains ont largué sur le Cambodge trois fois plus de bombes
des CPK also considered Phnom Penh City dwellers. My apology. The CPK did not regard the city dwellers as enemies.
Pour le PCK, les citadins n'étaient pas
contrary
des ennemis,
to the allegations made by the prosecution.
Qu'avance l'accusation.
On the other hand, those Phnom Penh city dwellers
les
were mostly workers, peasants,
principalement des ouvriers,
petty bourgeoisies and
des
intellectuals,
des intellectuels,
whom the CPK needed and needed to gather their forces and strength
avait
in order to build the revolution.
De leur force pour construire la révolution.
I also would like to respond
j'aimerais
to the co-prosecutor's allegation that the DK regime was a slave state.
Comme quoi le régime du Cambodge
it is simply not true.
Esclavagiste. Ce n'est pas vrai.
I would like to inform my compatriots that CPK did not struggle to liberate the country for the purpose of transforming its people into slavery as alleged.
D'asservir la population
On the
comme
contrary,
par l'accusation.
The CPK
bien au contraire,
liberated the people
le PCK
from slavery.
A libéré le peuple qui
we
était
all should have known that before the liberation
nous
on 17 April 1975,
majority
of the peasants were poor, could
la
not support themselves on a daily basis, and faced grave difficulty in their living condition.
Confrontés à de graves difficultés.
The local authority at the time failed to provide a proper public service and social welfare to the poor people.
Ni de protection sociale pour les pauvres.
Corruption was ripe
la corruption
and
était
injustice rooted deeply in Cambodian society.
Et l'injustice était profondément enracinée dans la société cambodgienne.
This resulted in people becoming poorer
du coup,
and poorer.
Les gens sont devenus
poor
de plus
people
en plus
needed
pauvres.
To borrow money from
les
the rich in order to support their living,
emprunter de l'argent
for medical treatment
pour pouvoir
and to pay tax.
Subvenir à leurs besoins.
That was the time
se
the rich
soigner,
exploited the situation.
Les riches ont
they persecuted
de la situation.
The poor. They demanded interest as they pleased,
exigeant
and monthly interest could skyrocket as much as 50% of the capital.
Usuriers, les intérêts mensuels
as a result of this excessive interest rate, people could no longer afford to pay their debt
de
and creditors confiscated farms, rice paddy and houses.
Ainsi,
and when they no longer had
riz,
any farm,
maison,
rice paddy or house,
plus, ni ferme,
they were forced
ni riz,
to work
maison,
as slaves.
Ils étaient contraints de travailler
in order
comme des esclaves
to pay debt that was
pour rembourser
never ended.
Une dette dont ils ne pouvaient jamais venir à bout.
In many instances, they were forced to sell their children to work for others.
Bien souvent, ils étaient obligés de vendre leurs enfants.
Became their slaves merely in exchange for food.
Travaillaient comme des esclaves pour d'autres personnes en échange de nourriture.
This exploitation and the poorness of these people was one of the many causes
et la misère de la
that the CPK determined to resolve by liberating the nation and people from slavery, from human exploitation and invasion by other countries, by building a country where people could live equally and own the country with independence, self-mastery, self-reliance, and decide on destiny
de
and nation.
Un pays où on décidait de son destin.
The CPK did not design any policy or plan to have its people placed in slavery
le PCK n'a jamais
by food deprivation,
une quelconque
forced labor,
ou plan
or killing.
Destiné à réduire la population en esclavage, en les
on the contrary,
en les
in mid-1976, the Standing Committee prepared and adopted the four-year planning to build socialism
un
in all
plan
fields.
Sur quatre ans pour la construction du socialisme dans
the
tous
CPK
les domaines.
Line and policy was to promote
la
the livelihood
du PCK
of the people.
Consistait à améliorer les moyens de subsistance
this
de la
plan
population.
Set forth a food regime for people.
Le plan
that is, each person would receive certain tang or 312 kilograms of rice per year. So people would have enough food and they could have 3 to 4 meals per day
les gens auraient donc assez à manger
with two courses, a soup and a fried dish.
Par jour,
in addition, additional food and dessert would be provided
de plats,
every 3 days.
Et un plat frit. De plus,
in 1977
des rations supplémentaires
and
ainsi que
every 2 days in 1978
assuré tous les trois jours.
And every day from 1979 onwards.
Et tous les jours à partir de 1979.
As for work hours, people would be allowed to work 8 hours per day and would be entitled to 3 days off per month. Pregnant women would be allowed a 2-month maternity leave after delivery. Sick people could rest depending on actual conditions. In addition, we prepared to increase machinery to reduce physical workload of the people.
Nous étions préparés à.
This shows that the CPK stance was not to force people to work hard.
Permettant de réduire le travail physique de la population. Ceci démontre que la position du PCK.
I recall that one day I traveled to Siem Reap province via Kampong Thom at night.
Je me souviens.
I saw people walk to the rice fields, and I asked local cadres about this, and I was told that people had high commitment to work extra hours. Only after 1979 did I learn that local cadres lied to me. Concerning healthcare, the CPK prepared a 4-year planning for medicine with a total amount of $35,270,000. The 4-year expenditure for clothing was $66,270,000. For housing, hygiene and culture, the 4-year expenditure was $80,230,000. The CPK clearly and specifically set out these plans for zones and autonomous sectors to implement it. The CPK did not design any plan or policy to kill people. On the contrary, it had planned to increase population and not to reduce it. However, it is so regretful that zones and autonomous sectors did not implement the Standing Committee's decision.
N'est pas mis en œuvre les décisions du comité permanent.
Up to now, I can conclude and respond to questions put forth by the court and especially by the public that the strategic events that happened during the DK period were caused by the following reasons.
Les événements stratégiques s'étant produits pendant la période du Kampuchea.
The CPK made incorrect decision to recruit some cadres. As they betrayed, they did not grasp well the party line, and some leaders occupied themselves with works in Phnom Penh and failed to visit cooperatives regularly. True. Some zone and autonomous sector leaders and cadres were Vietnamese and American infiltrated agents who betrayed the revolution. They carried out activities to destroy the CPK movement, the people, and the country of Cambodia. They did not follow the CPK policy and instructions. Instead, they killed and mistreated people by starving them and arbitrarily engaging them in forced labor. They concealed these facts and fabricated reports to the Party Central Committee. They resorted to all kinds of methods to make people upset with and turn against the revolution. This weakened the revolution and made it vulnerable to enemies' invasion. Under the pretext to liberate the people, thus legitimized its invasion. As a matter of fact,
par les the East Zone leaders deprived people of food
and secretly exported rice to Vietnam.
Les chefs de la zone Est privaient la population de
they were the ones who seemed to burn the outer skin crisp while leaving the inside raw. They excessively implemented the CPK policy.
C'était eux qui faisaient en sorte que la
the fresh they left the inside raw infers that they did not engage in anything at all, but left their lower cadres do whatever they pleased.
Ils ont appliqué la politique du PCK de façon
a large number
excessive.
Of cadres at zone, autonomous
Lorsque
sector, district, and cooperative
cru,
level failed to sufficiently grasp the CPK line planning and policy. They failed to report the situation concerning hardship and shortage faced by the people. Instead, they fortified their reports to the party center by boasting about their achievement and success in leading their respective base. And to achieve what they fabricated in the reports, they resorted to forcing people to overwork, reducing their food ration and killing them arbitrarily. In summary, the CPK had clear reasons for the evacuation of people. The evacuation was to ensure their safety and to liberate them from slavery and injustice. It was never meant to place them in slavery. On the issue of fair trial, Your Honours, it is my observation throughout this proceeding that some of my fundamental rights have been violated. Actually, I would not say the trial is because I am asking the court to find justice for me. And if the chamber is upset because of my criticism,
je demande justice à la chambre.
Then the injustice indeed falls upon me. However, if I don't raise the issue of my rights being violated, the chance to find justice for me
au risque
is even slimmer as those rights are fundamental to seeking my justice.
Je ne soulève pas
concerning this point, I have carefully followed and observed the court's proceedings,
j'ai encore moins de chances d'obtenir justice,
and I submit that my many rights have been violated.
Fondamentaux à la justice. J'ai suivi et observé
namely,
de près
one, inequality of arms in collecting evidence. Throughout the proceedings, my counsels were not allowed to conduct any investigation for the purpose of collecting evidence for my defense. However, the co-prosecutors had ample opportunity to conduct their own investigation since the beginning.
Le bureau des coprocureurs a eu
my counsels were not allowed to seek for other witnesses except those whose names are on the co-investigating judges' list. This apparently tied my counsel's arms and restricted them from gathering evidence for my defense, while the other side was afforded full opportunity to attack me freely. This has severely affected my defense team and my legitimate interest.
Ceci
true, failure to summon important witnesses.
Deuxième point.
My defense counsel repeatedly requested the chamber to summon some important witnesses
à plusieurs reprises par
to
les
testify before this chamber, namely character witnesses and
des témoins de
witnesses
concernant les événements de Tolpochre.
However, the chamber denied such request.
La chambre
Such decisions have seriously impacted the process of ascertaining the truth in this case.
Three,
bias in examination of witnesses before the chamber. The examination of witnesses is an important process in ascertaining the truth and clarify some uncertainties regarding some witnesses.
Est un processus important dans la manifestation de la vérité.
Your honors are to rely upon these testimonies when you make your just decision. In this chamber, I can see that your honors have failed to consider this issue properly.
Mais je constate que cette chambre n'a pas tenu
during the prosecution's examination of witnesses, your honors always afforded them the opportunity with minimal interruption, despite objections raised by the defense. The defense lawyers, however, were not that lucky as they were not allowed such opportunity. They were interrupted most of the time by the objections from the prosecution, and your honors always agreed with the prosecutor's objections.
And
sometimes when the defense lawyers raised their objections, instead of being sustained,
lorsque la défense soulevait des objections,
and it receives
au lieu d'être
warnings
retenu,
from the president of the chamber.
Avec des avertissements
As
du président
we could
de la
see,
chambre.
The unequal treatment Kirsten Paul and I decided to no longer testify before the chamber anymore because we thought that, to your honors, our testimonies mean nothing
as
you are clearly biased. And the proceedings that have been conducted in this chamber are just for the sake of completing the procedure or making it look good in the eye of the public. In conclusion, based on the three grounds that I have stated above, it clearly shows that I did not carry out any plan to commit the crimes. I did not provide any support or encourage anyone to commit the crimes. Despite the fact that I had a role as Deputy Secretary of the CPK and President of the People's Representative Assembly, I did not have any knowledge of the crimes committed at the base level.
Dans la perpétration de crimes, malgré
only
mon rôle
toward the end of the DK period
had
I learned
peuple,
the treacherous acts committed by leaders at some zones, sectors, and bases. They had the intention to destroy the CPK movement, and at that time I did not have any effective authority to prevent those treacherous acts, nor had I any role in controlling the armed forces or local authorities. If I had any authority to lead or commit the alleged crimes during the DK period, surely the court that was established in 1979 by the People's Republic of Cambodia would have prosecuted and convicted me like Pol Pot and Ieng Sary. Evidence of those crimes at the time was still fresh, and apparently there is no need to wait for 38 years to try me. However, they knew that I had no authority and did not commit any crime.
Mais ils savaient bien que je n'avais aucune autorité et que je n'avais commis aucun crime.
Nonetheless, I would like to express my deepest remorse and moral responsibility to all victims.
Néanmoins, je voudrais exprimer
and Cambodian people who suffered during the democratic Cambodia regime.
Vis-à-vis de toutes les victimes et du peuple
As a matter of historical fact, the CPK's policy, line, and plan were solely designed for one purpose and one purpose only, that is to liberate the country and people from colonization, imperialism, exploitation, extreme poverty, interfering and invasion by neighboring countries, especially by Vietnam. The CPK's policy was clear and specific. It wanted to create an equal society where people are the masters of their country for the purpose of independence, self-mastery, self-reliance, and deciding its own destiny and nation. The CPK movement was not designed for killing people or destroying the country. My conscience, my hope and wishes were destroyed by those who betrayed the movement. My people suffered and killed. My nation fell apart. Although the tragedy in the decay period was the result of the acts committed by those traitors, in the name of Deputy Secretary of the Party that had the responsibility to disseminate and propagandize education about the CPK policy, I would like to sincerely apologize to the public, to the victims, their families, and all Cambodian people, and I still stand by my previously stated position that I am morally responsible for the loose and untidy control by the CPK. I wish to show my respect and pray for the lost souls that occurred by any means during the Democratic Cambodia period. In short, through this trial, I can see that justice is circumstantial. However, reality remains unchanged forever. Black cloud can never cover the entire sunlight. Likewise, bad and immoral people cannot tell lies and hide the reality from the eye of the people and the popular masses forever. They cannot hide the reality of courageous struggle by the Cambodian people and the support afforded to them by the people in the world who loved peace and justice. Therefore, Your Honours, based on the evidence and reasons I have stated above, and especially the closing statements made by my defense team, I respectfully submit to Your Honors to acquit me from all the charges and accordingly release me.
Je demande à la Chambre de m'acquitter sur
tous les chefs d'accusation
et de bien vouloir me libérer. Je vous remercie.
President, thank you. Security guards, please bring the accused back into where he sat
earlier. Garde de sécurité, veuillez reconduire l'accusé à sa place.
President, the chamber would like now to give the floor to Nguyen Chia's counsel.
La parole est maintenant donnée aux avocats de Nguyen Chia.
Your final rebuttal statement. You may proceed.
Pour leur réponse finale. Vous avez la parole.
Mr. President, Your Honours, good morning, Council.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Everybody.
Bonjour, Mesdames et Messieurs les juges.
In the public gallery.
Bonjour à mes confrères, aux parties civiles, aux membres du public.
Yesterday I indicated that I would speak for 30 minutes.
Que j'aurais besoin
but
de
having
30
heard
minutes,
afterwards that the Khieu-San Phan team will
après
use only 1 hour of its time,
la défense de I would hope n'aura besoin
that
que d'une
the chamber
heure.
Would allow me to speak 15 or 20 minutes extra
in
my rebuttal to the submissions yesterday of the prosecution.
Afin que je puisse répondre aux répliques de l'accusation.
Nevertheless,
hier.
Mr. President, I will try to be as brief as possible
je serai
and try to respond
le plus
directly
possible.
To the arguments
je
of the prosecution
de
and the civil parties.
Aux arguments
and in general,
mis en avant
I would like to address the arguments
civiles.
Advanced by each counsel.
J'aborderai les arguments
and although I may by necessity move around because of the overlap between
avocat,
the various counsels' arguments.
Mais ces arguments se chevauchant
Mr.
Parfois,
President, Your Honour, let me begin by addressing
parfois,
the comments advanced yesterday by the civil
temps,
parties.
Je vais tout d'abord, répondre aux commentaires
the first
formulés
observation
par les
I will make concerns
hier.
The civil parties' parroting of the OCP's phrase slave state.
Par les parties civiles de la
we have heard this catchphrase now many times.
État esclavagiste.
Like
c'est
an
slogan que nous avons
advertising campaign,
à maintes reprises.
The civil parties and the prosecution have flashed it in our faces like a neon sign,
et les coprocureurs
all in an attempt to argue
une enseigne
that it epitomized the common purpose of the CPK.
Que ceci incarne l'objectif commun du PCK.
As we have expressed in both our brief
comme
and in oral argument,
dans notre
the use of this slogan,
orale,
slogan of slave state,
slogan
is not correct and is in fact misleading.
Est incorrect et trompeur.
Not just because of its inaccuracy in describing the workings of the CPK,
il ne s'agit non seulement
but also because it is based on evidence
du fonctionnement
that
du
is
PCK,
not at issue before this
mais
chamber.
Il est également basé sur des preuves
what
dans
do
la
I mean when I say that
saisie.
This is not at issue before this chamber?
Donc, qu'est-ce que je veux dire
I mean that it is grounded in witness statements and evidence
la chambre
that are
n'est pas
outside
saisie de ces preuves,
the scope
bien parce que ces
of case
002/01. Déclarations de témoins et sur des preuves qui ne relèvent
Mr.
pas
President,
de la
this trial, as we are all well
01.
Aware, concerns
comme
two population movements and the alleged Tulpo-Che crime
deux
site.
Transferts de population et le prétendu site
cooperatives
d'exécution
and
de
their
Tulpo-Che.
Corresponding conditions are not a part of this trial.
Les coopératives et les conditions
despite this,
dans celles-ci ne font
prosecution
pas
and civil
partie
parties have tried to backdoor
procès.
Witness statements
et malgré cela,
recounting cooperative
les procureurs
conditions
et les parties civiles
to show
ont tenté par des moyens détournés de s'appuyer
like
sur
slaves.
Des déclarations de témoins racontant les conditions
having failed
dans
to use this phrase in
their
closing
brief, que certains
the civil parties
étaient traités
following
comme des
the prosecution
des esclaves,
almost blindly now do the
sans
same.
Sans avoir utilisé cette phrase dans leur mémoire de clôture, les parties civiles
Mr. President,
suivent
Your Honor, it cannot be stated more explicitly
et font de même.
All of the witness statements alleging individuals in cooperatives were subjected to slave-like conditions outside,
dans les coopératives ont
outside
été soumis
the scope of case
002/01.
We have not been able to examine them or test their relevance
01.
Or reliability.
Nous n'avons donc pas pu
civil parties and the prosecution have made no effort to show whether these statements,
ou la pertinence de ces
based entirely on witness observations
les
of conditions on the ground, are in any way remotely representative of the country as a whole.
Si ces déclarations basées entièrement
by
sur
using the slave state slogan, the prosecution
de
and civil parties have tried to have their proverbial cake and eat it too.
En employant
they
le
have
slogan État esclavagiste,
a sensational and evocative tagline to advance their allegations,
le beurre et l'argent
all
du beurre,
the while keeping the evidence underlying it safe
ce
from scrutiny.
Dramatique
as it is based on evidence that is not part of this trial, its relevance ends.
En nous empêchant d'examiner ces preuves.
The President, Mr. Nunjia, you may.
Le Président.
Please hold on, Mr. Nunchi has something to say. Mr. Nunchi, you may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
The President. Mr. Nunchi, you want to be returned to the holding cell downstairs?
Vous demandez à rentrer dans votre cellule temporaire.
You may leave the courtroom. Security guards are now instructed to bring Mr. Mr. Nunchi to the holding cell downstairs.
Dans sa cellule de détention provisoire.
Mr. Copé, you may now resume your statement.
Vous pouvez reprendre.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Maître Copé. Merci, Monsieur le Président.
As I said earlier, by using the slave state slogan,
comme je l'indiquais
the
donc,
prosecution and civil parties have tried to have their cake and eat it too.
État esclavagiste, les parties civiles et les coprocureurs,
they have conjured a sensational
and
evocative tagline to advance their allegation, all the while keeping the evidence underlying it safe from scrutiny.
Appuyer leurs affirmations
as it is based on evidence that is not
preuves.
Part of
cette
this
affirmation
trial,
est
its relevance and substance remain untested by the defense.
Dans la portée de ce procès,
indeed,
la défense
the defense itself
n'a donc pas pu tester
requested
la
this evidence be included in this trial.
De ces preuves,
request
la défense
that the prosecution
a demandé
objected
à incorporer
to,
ces preuves au sein,
underscoring
du
their
champ
fear
de
that they did not want to risk exposing these allegations to the light of day.
Craignant que
and, Mr. President, the civil parties have applied this tactic in other ways. We can see it, for instance, in their claim that 2 million deaths occurred during the Democratic Cambodia period. This allegation of 2 million deaths is again based on untested evidence. Why? Because the report it is based on is not part of this trial. It has not been examined by the parties. The demographer who created it has not been called here in this courtroom as an expert witness. Why? Again, Mr. President, the answer is simple, because the total number of deaths alleged
Pourquoi?
During Democratic Cambodia is not a part
Puisque
of this trial.
Le nombre total de victimes
could it be that both the civil parties and the prosecution are suffering from acute amnesia
ne fait pas partie
when faced
de ce procès.
With the charges at issue in case 002/01?
Souffrent-ils d'amnésie
Have they somewhat
conveniently
forgotten that this case only
concerns
two population movements and two for trade.
Que ce dossier ne concerne que les deux déplacements
While
de
I could
population
sympathize with
le
the symptoms of a failing memory, even this explanation seems too generous.
De perte de mémoire, mais cette
Whatever
explication
their excuse
me
may be, Mr. President, trial chamber cannot condone this mode of
la
proceeding.
Ne sera
Allowing the prosecution and the civil parties to base claims on untested evidence outside the scope of this trial violates basic principles of the right to a fair trial. And the chamber must accordingly give such assertions no weight whatsoever.
La chambre doit donc ne doit accorder aucun
the,
poids à ce genre d'affirmation.
What I would like to call sensationalizing of witness statements has not been limited to
Donner
outside
un
the scope
sensationnel
of trial.
Aux déclarations de témoins, cela
Evidence
ne s'est pas
within the scope of case
002/01
has been treated by the civil parties and the prosecution in the same manner.
L'accusation et la partie civile ont agi de la même
Examples
manière
of this are seen in the civil parties' use of allegations that Khmer Rouge cadre killed babies
la façon dont la
and people with glasses.
Exploite
These witness allegations cannot be used as the poster children for Democratic
Cambodia.
The reality is that these claims are unrepresentative of the experiences of individuals during Democratic Cambodia. Their misuse in describing a policy of the Khmer Rouge is therefore disingenuous and it must be disregarded. Your Honours, I would like to pause for a moment
écarté.
And reflect on the allegation made by the civil parties yesterday morning
aux allégations faites
that in defending our client we have somehow made a mockery of the civil
notre
parties.
Client, nous serions moqués des
this is unwarranted.
Ceci
the defence has never denied
La
the suffering
n'a jamais nié
of the civil parties.
Les souffrances des parties civiles.
We have never called them liars.
Nous Ne les avons
In fact,
jamais qualifiés de
we offer the utmost sympathy
réalité,
to their suffering.
Fait part de notre
we have, as we are tasked, with doing as defense attorneys, made very precise claims challenging the evidence against our client.
Des arguments précis.
If the civil parties cannot appreciate this distinction, it reveals on their part, we would say, a serious misunderstanding about the role of a defense attorney. In their rebuttal yesterday, the civil parties attempted to paint a picture that the defense has put forward an entirely unrepresentative image of the CPK, an image, they say, that is not supported by the evidence. They have cited to various references in our closing brief in an attempt to show that our assertions are outside the scope of the realities of democratic Cambodia. They point to our use of language to further this argument, labeling such words as evacuation and liberation as prime examples of what they call Orwellian newspeak.
Certains termes que nous employons.
To this, Your Honours, we simply remind that parties that these terms are used continually by all the parties throughout the course of this trial. These terms, Mr. President, are taken straight from the closing order itself. And we can only speculate that if the lawyer for the civil parties had perhaps read the closing order with more care, such terms as evacuation or liberation may not have come as such a surprise. In contrast, while the civil parties coined phrases like after liberation straight to the killing fields, we have remained measured in our use of language. Finally, Mr. President, it is with irony that the defense addresses the final claim of the civil parties, that the defense is guilty of misrepresenting the evidence to suit our own narrative. Specifically, the civil parties attack our use of witness Lei Bonny's testimony that the physical conditions of evacuees during the second population movement was both good and normal. The civil parties proclaim that, and I quote, if the defense had read but four lines more, unquote, of Lei Bonny's testimony, cite, it would have been apparent that Lei Bonny also testified suivantes, elle aurait vu que that the evacuees had le corps des swollen bodies et que and that they received less food than pigs. Mr. President, Your Honor, the defense did in fact read those additional lines of testimony and noted that those lines did not address the second population movement, but instead reference conditions after resettlement in cooperatives in Pusat.
La situation postérieure
to the conditions in the new cooperatives, Lei Bonny observed, and I quote,
par rapport aux conditions
that, however, when time passed by, we did not have enough
cite,
food to eat.
À mesure que le temps
we
a passé,
ate a food that was very little.
Nous plus eu assez à manger.
We ate food that made us become, you know, our body parts become swollen.
Ingérée, notre
and we believed, at that time, we noted that the pigs were even given more food than they gave to human beings.
Plus end que of les humains. Fin de citation.
Your Honours, I now turn to the co-prosecutor's submissions concerning our arguments about the fairness of this trial. The co-prosecutors, in an attempt to gloss over these violations, advance the argument that in allowing the defense their two allocated days of oral argument, the chamber somehow showed its commitment to the fair trial rights of our client.
Le droit de l'accusé à un procès équitable.
The co-prosecutors seem to suggest that in granting us this time, all the fair trial violations have been absolved.
Laisse ainsi entendre que grâce à
to
ce
this
temps
statement,
de plaidoirie,
we can only ask,
toutes les violations du droit à un
low?
Procès équitable seraient pardonnées comme par magie.
The answer to that question
nous
is yes.
Que poser la question suivante. Est-ce qu'on a placé la barre si bas? La
as the chamber knows,
oui, comme le sait la
the
chambre,
most important of these fair trial violations concerns
la
witness Heng Samrin,
du droit à un procès
the witness at the heart of our fair trial argument,
Samrin,
whose presence at this trial
dont la
we called
ici
earlier a non-negotiable bare minimum for securing a fair proceeding.
Une condition minimale non négociable pour
Heng Samrin,
que l'on puisse parler d'un procès équitable.
Of paramount importance to the charges
Yen
at issue at this trial.
Était un témoin d'une importance cruciale
Penh,
concernant
the events at
les chefs d'accusation retenus pour ce
and
procès, à savoir l'allocation de Phnom Penh, les événements
de Potrey
et la politique alléguée consistant à tuer
Heng Samrin, a witness in possession of important exculpatory evidence that directly exonerates our client from the allegation that he had intended the killing of former Lon Nol soldiers and officials.
Heng Samrin, the
one selon lesquelles and only
il aurait
character witness requested by
Nguyen Chia. De faire exécuter les anciens soldats et fonctionnaires de Lon Nol. Heng Samrin était aussi le seul témoin de personnalité demandé par la défense de
Nguyen Chia.
Toutes les personnes ici présentes devraient se poser une question.
What have you heard from the co-prosecutors and the civil parties in reference to the failure of the chamber to summon Heng Samrin?
N'a pas cité à comparaître Heng Samrin.
Nothing.
Rien du tout.
Absolute silence.
Silence total.
The co-prosecutors and the civil parties have not responded to the substance of our complaint at all.
Même de notre grief.
And there are numerous arguments the parties could have
les
made regarding our request to call Heng Samrin during this trial,
de voir citer à comparaître
but nothing
Heng
has been said.
Mais rien n'a été dit.
For instance, they could have
Par
argued
exemple,
that the evidence
ils auraient pu
Heng Samrin had to offer was not important.
Que possédait Heng Samrin
or that it was evidence that could have been established
ou que
by different
ces éléments auraient pu être établis par d'autres témoins.
They could have argued that evidence of Nguyen Chia's character was not relevant,
le témoignage
or argued that
de
there were other higher-ranking military witnesses that could have been heard.
Témoins militaires de haut rang qui auraient pu être entendus.
They could have attempted to argue that there was already sufficient evidence of Nguyen Chia's intent and that Heng Samrin's testimony was therefore not needed.
En conséquence de quoi
But did they make any of these claims?
No,
they did not.
Mais de tels arguments ont-ils été avancés? Non.
Mr. President, Your Honors,
Heng
Samrin is the elephant in the room.
C'est l'éléphant dans la pièce.
The co-prosecutors and the civil parties dare not speak.
Dont l'accusation et la partie civile n'osent pas parler.
Why is it that they are rendered mute by this man?
Cet homme les rend comme muets?
Why not talk about it like Craig Edgerton did this morning in the Phnom Penh Post?
Ce matin, Craig Edgerton dans le Phnom Penh Post.
We can think of two reasons.
Deux raisons nous viennent à l'esprit.
They either agree that his presence is of paramount importance and a fair trial cannot be had without his testimony,
sans la déposition de cette personne,
or they are simply not allowed to even mention his name.
Ils ne sont tout simplement pas autorisés, ne fût-ce qu'à mentionner ce nom.
Your Honours would be
Dans
a remarkable position about these proceedings.
En dit long sur ce procès.
If the answer is
si
that the parties cannot even discuss the nature and degree of this fair trial violation
examiner nature et le degré
and the extent
de cette violation
to which the co-prosecutors remain
équitable,
in the government's clutches
is
even worse than we thought.
Est encore davantage sous l'emprise
if the answer is that a fair trial is impossible without his presence,
si la réponse est
then we have confirmation from all parties that our client's fair trial rights
alors
have been irreparably
toutes les parties
harmed.
Confirment que les droits de notre client à un procès équitable ont été
the international co-prosecutor, Mr.
Kumudjian,
also addressed our argument that this trial
a également abordé notre
is fundamentally political.
Politique.
We heard him say yesterday
Hier,
that he denies that claim.
Il a dit qu'il rejetait une telle affirmation.
He says that this trial is not about politics,
pas une question de politique,
but about law.
Mais bien de droit.
Mr. President, we disagree. We have submitted that a proceeding such as this
Pour nous,
could never
un tel procès
separate law
ne
from politics.
Jamais séparer le droit de la politique.
That a tribunal
Selon
such as this infuses law with politics.
Mêle droit et politique.
And let it be clear, this
que
view is not constructed
clair,
from thin air.
Cet avis ne surgit pas
it
de
is not
nulle
woven
part.
In the minds of a paranoid defense
lawyer. De
it is a viewpoint with a long pedigree in the history of international criminal proceedings.
Dans les procès pénaux internationaux.
The Indian judge,
le
Justice Paul,
Indien
gave serious consideration in his dissenting opinion at the Tokyo Tribunal
l'opinion
to the question
rendue au tribunal
of whether
de Tokyo,
victors of a war
la question de savoir
can
si les
fairly judge its losers.
Équitablement juger les perdants.
And respected academics
chercheurs
did the same.
Respectés ont fait la même chose.
Nguyen-Chi's view that he cannot be fairly judged by representatives of the two principal victors is a serious argument
par les représentants des deux principaux vainqueurs, c'est là un argument sérieux qui mérite une réflexion sérieuse.
And if this trial is about law and facts and not politics,
est un procès de droit qui concerne les faits et non pas la politique,
why do the prosecutors so consistently ignore facts that are legally relevant to the charges?
Des faits qui sont juridiquement en rapport avec
Mr.
les
Lysak informed this chamber yesterday that the prosecutor's final brief included 40 pages of historical analysis. But the question is which
Mais la question est de savoir de quelle histoire il s'agit.
Why does it describe
Pourquoi
the CBK's alleged violence prior to
1975
with almost
BCK
no mention of the American bombing?
Sans pratiquement mentionner les bombardements américains,
or of the atrocities committed by Lonel's forces
against
CBK cadres?
Contre les cadres du BCK par les forces de
Was the CBK fighting a war against the Phantom?
Menait
or was
la guerre
it fighting a war
fantôme,
against an enemy?
Ou contre un ennemi?
Does anyone doubt that the intent of the CPK's alleged policies against enemies changes radically in light of the ruthlessness of the enemy it was actually fighting? Nor are more powerful actors equally responsible for conduct identical to that for which our client stands charged, accused of identical crimes?
Et poursuivi notre
client,
ne sont pas accusés de crimes identiques. Est-ce que l'accusation oserait accuser ceux qui dirigent le pays, ceux qui sont responsables d'avoir mis en œuvre les politiques de notre client?
Monsieur le Président, mesdames et messieurs les juges,
la réponse à cette question est bien sûr négative.
The answer is that the prosecutors who claim this trial has nothing to do with politics
n'a rien à voir avec la politique,
cannot even bring themselves to say
même pas
Heng Samrin's name.
Heng Samrin.
They cannot even bring themselves to contest the defense claim that the trial and the investigation were unfair.
Comme quoi, l'instruction et le procès n'étaient pas équitables.
Let me now, Mr. President,
à présent,
turn to the crimes which were discussed jointly by Mr. Rayner and Mr. Lysak.
And
I will begin with the evacuation of Phnom Penh. With regard to the evacuation
sujet,
of Phnom Penh, I would simply like to clarify a serious misunderstanding of our oral argument which became apparent yesterday and which may have caused some confusion during our client's speech here this morning.
Hier et qui aurait pu causer de la confusion au cours de l'intervention
As our
de notre
brief
client
explains,
ce matin, comme indiqué
and
dans notre mémoire,
our client repeated
et comme
again
répété
here in this morning,
par notre client ce
evacuation
matin,
of Phnom Penh
l'évacuation
was driven by
de
a variety
Phnom Penh était motivée
of
par plusieurs considérations,
These included the food
y compris
within Phnom Penh
l'approvisionnement
in more generally,
en alimentaire à Phnom Penh
the effects of
et
the
au
US
Cambodge
bombing,
plus généralement,
and the state of Cambodia's economic infrastructure, including its rice paddies, as of 17 April 1975. Our submissions before the investigating judges in this chamber consistently emphasized all of these factors as integral to the decision to evacuate and the manner in which it was carried out. Yesterday,
Hier,
the co-prosecutor seized on a single sentence in my Cambodian colleague's remarks from last week
par mon confrère
to the effect
la semaine passée,
that the evacuation would still have been carried out had the food crisis in Phnom Penh not existed.
Même en l'absence de crise alimentaire à Phnom Penh.
Prosecutors argued that this sentence amounts to a concession that neither the American bombing nor the food supply were relevant to the forced transfer charges.
Les bombardements américains ni le ravitaillement
and Mr. President, that of course
un quelconque rapport avec
was a misstatement of our position
de transfert forcé.
And of reality.
Ceci revient à déformer notre
Those
position
facts
et
are
la
critically,
réalité.
Critically relevant now,
sont d'une
as they have always been
aujourd'hui,
to
comme
Nguyen Chi's defense.
Dans le contexte de la défense de Nguyen Chi.
First, as Sonnerun explained, the bombing devastated Cambodia's economic infrastructure and its ability to produce food.
Du Cambodge, ainsi que sa
that, that reality was a fundamental aspect of the CPK's conclusion
était
that the economy could not support
le PCK
unproductive cities in a society
que
in which economic production was driven entirely by the rice paddy.
Subvenir aux besoins de villes improductives dans une société où la production économique entièrement
the evacuation would have looked very different
comme l'a expliqué had
an impending catastrophe of starvation not existed.
Bien différente s'il n'y avait pas
during yesterday's hearing as they have
catastrophe
throughout this trial the co-prosecutors repeatedly attacked the evacuation not for the fact
hier,
that it happened
comme pendant tout le
but
procès,
for the way
l'accusation
it happened
a attaqué
including its immediacy and the fact that it affected all of the residents of Phnom Penh
pour son existence même, mais bien pour la
but
manière
those
dont elle s'est
are
déroulée,
precisely the features of the
y
evacuation
pour son
which were driven by the threat of imminent starvation
pour le fait
including the fact
tous les résidents de
that 6 days worth
or, ce sont
of food remained in the city on 17 April 1975
qui était lié à la menace d'une famille.
So Mr. President, the arguments that you heard yesterday which implied that we had somehow abandoned the food supply and U.S. bombing arguments
were misguided. Les arguments entendus hier, selon
my final remark
nous
about evacuation of Phnom Penh is that both the civil parties
erronés.
And the co-prosecutors
toujours
again make the claim that Nguyen Chia did not subject
himself
to
cross-examination.
Nguyen Chia subjected himself to 12 days of cross-examination,
il a été interrogé pendant
some of which was described by Mr. Lysak yesterday.
Hier, Lysak en a d'ailleurs parlé.
And he refused to continue only because of the violations of his right to challenge the evidence against him during the appearance of Mr. Steve Hatter.
À mettre à l'épreuve les éléments
so, Mr. President, Your Honours, hopefully we can put to rest this myth that our client refused to testify about the
J'espère
evacuation.
Qu'on peut donc faire un sort à ce mythe selon quoi notre client aurait refusé de déposer sur l'évacuation.
I would like to turn now to certain comments made by the co-prosecutors concerning the second population movement.
Sur le deuxième déplacement de population.
While addressing the second population movement, the co-prosecutors
à ce sujet,
misconstrued our argument,
a déformé
claiming
notre
that
argument,
we had said that the second transfer was implemented
que le
by
transfert
rogue
a été
zonal
mis
leaders,
en par des chefs
that
de
the
zone
second transfer was in fact a rogue operation.
Il s'agirait donc
we have never said it was rogue.
Jamais dit que cela était quelque
this
chose
portrayal of the second movement is their formulation,
terme
and it is nonsense. Mr. President, our point was, and still is,
et c'est un terme
that
absurde.
The second movement
nous
was the prerogative of the zones.
Que ce deuxième déplacement était la
prerogative that both
des zones.
Nous disons Rosnim and Sao Pim, leaders
Sao Pim,
of the two zones allegedly instrumental in the second
de
population movement, were not mere zone leaders,
dans le
but powerful members of the standing committee.
Des chefs de zone, mais aussi des membres puissants du
as a matter of fact, founding members of the CPK,
des membres fondateurs du PCK,
and at least equally as powerful as Nguyen Chia and Pol Pot.
Pol Pot et
and that the evidence before this chamber supports the conclusion that it was the zones
la chambre
that had primary control and authority over the second
les
population
zones
movement.
Qui ont exercé leur contrôle.
Next, Mr. President,
et leur
I will turn to Tu Portray.
Je vais revenir
we have many things
Portray.
To say about Tu Portray and its underlying policy.
Sur les
but because of the time, I will limit myself to 6 key points.
Je me bornerai à aborder 6 grands points.
First,
premièrement,
the co-prosecutors
l'accusation
yesterday simply say nothing about any of the direct evidence that no policy of executing lone-wolf soldiers and officials existed.
Quant à l'absence de toute preuve directe
they say nothing about
people à l'existence.
They say nothing about Heng Samrin. They say nothing about
Ukbunchun. Sur Heng Samrin, sur
they do not challenge it. They do not contest it.
Ne conteste pas cela.
They do not tell the chamber that
chambre,
it is unreliable.
Que ces témoignages ne sont pas fiables.
They also do not tell the chamber how to resolve the direct contradiction between their position and this clear evidence
qui
from well-placed CPK insiders.
La thèse de l'accusation et ces témoignages clairs
As I have already observed, we claim that there was a violation of our client's right to a fair trial so serious that it required dismissal of all charges concerning
Tool-Portray.
And again, the co-prosecutors did not even mention it. And that is, we submit, remarkable, to say the least.
Doivent être classées sans suite. L'accusation n'en a même pas parlé.
Second, Mr. President, the co-prosecutors offered this chamber two pieces of evidence that a policy to execute lone-nose soldiers and officials existed.
D'une politique consistant à exécuter les soldats et fonctionnaires de l'armée.
And the first piece of evidence was a photo, of a group of people at the Ministry of Information,
au ministère de l'Information,
supposedly on 17 April 1975. Now, Mr. President, Your Honours, I would like to show that photo on the screen. And with your permission, Mr. President, I would like to do that now.
Le faire dès
and maybe to the AV unit, we could show it a few times in a row, because it's part of a little video.
Plusieurs fois, car elle fait partie d'un film vidéo.
The President, you may proceed.
Moments after this photograph is taken, this group of MPs and bureaucrats are led to a nearby tennis court and massacred. To round up and execute all those who were linked to the Lon Nol establishment. Moments after
Excuse me, Mr. President. The co-prosecutors called this photo of some
sur cette photo,
calmly
on voit des
standing
gens qui sont debout, calmes, les bras croisés,
and I quote,
et l'accusation
very strong
dit
evidence
que c'est là une preuve,
that every soldier
très forte,
and every official of the Khmer Republic
que tous les soldats et fonctionnaires de la République Khmer qui ont été
Cambodia,
tués dans tout le Cambodge
on
vers le 17 avril ou ce jour-là
was in fact killed, pursuant
l'ont été en application d'une politique du PCK.
This photo, Mr.
Cette
President, was one of the two pieces of evidence that the co-prosecutors claim
qui,
conclusively proves the existence of that policy.
De démontrer de façon concluante l'existence d'une telle politique.
Now maybe the co-prosecutors see a secret code in this photo that,
sur cette
that
photo,
we do
un
not.
Code secret qui nous échappe.
And contrary to the co-prosecutors' claims, we responded to this evidence directly in our oral argument last week.
Cet, élément de preuve la semaine dernière.
We conceded that the people
nous
depicted in this photo
les
were present
visibles sur la photo
at the Ministry of
Information,
which is all that this photo shows.
Montre cette photo.
We explained
nous
why that fact is irrelevant to any supposed
sans rapport
execution policy.
Avec toute supposée politique d'exécution.
Co-prosecutors chose not to respond to those arguments. Instead, they just reiterate the fact that these people were present at the Ministry of Information. And this supposedly
cette
very strong evidence
soi-disant
present is
très
irrelevant.
Forte, très solide et dénuée de pertinence.
The second piece of supposedly conclusive evidence was a series of quotations from
Duyck.
As we have argued
comme
before,
nous l'avons soutenu,
Duyck has admitted
Duyck
to having had no basis to make any conclusions with regard to CPK policy.
Pour tirer des conclusions
his testimony
la du PCK.
Is irrelevant.
Sa déposition est
however,
de pertinence.
I will add that even the irrelevant excerpts
si les
cited by the co-prosecutors yesterday
de pertinence
establish
cités par
that no execution policy existed.
Pouvait être pris
yesterday,
en
the prosecution quoted Duyck saying, and I quote,
politique.
During that initial stage, people were evacuated and then some of the senior soldiers were arrested
soldats de haut
and
rang
secretly
ont été
killed.
Arrêtés et tués en secret.
End of quote.
Fin citation.
We do not know
nous
how Duyck came
Duyck
to this conclusion.
À une telle conclusion.
But even this evidence suggests that only senior soldiers were apparently executed.
De haut rang ont
and
été
even
exécutés.
Then, that only
même
some
dans ce cas-là,
of those
cela
senior soldiers were executed.
Que certains de ces soldats de haut rang ont été exécutés.
And the co-prosecutor's other evidence from Duyck was just
les
as inconsistent with this supposed policy.
Épinglé par l'accusation ne cadre pas avec
as the prosecution noted, Judge Laverne asked Duyck in case 001 whether people linked to the Lon Nol regime were executed.
A demandé à Duyck si les gens associés
now,
au régime
Duyck
de Lon Nol avaient été exécutés.
Duyck's answer
et
was as follows,
voici la
and
réponse
I quote,
donnée par Duyck. Je cite.
People in Lon Nol's
les gens du régime
were
de Lon Nol étaient classés
into three
en trois catégories.
first category referred to the people who were smashed secretly. Now this is the point where the co-prosecutors stopped reading.
Que l'accusation a mis fin à sa lecture.
But as your chamber is well aware, the excerpt continues.
Cet extrait se poursuit.
And I quote,
je vais citer.
The second category referred to the people who were detained in the re-education camp.
Détenus dans des camps
and
de
the third category referred to the people who were regarded as the new
people.
So this is the co-prosecutor's final concluding evidence of a policy of systematically hunting down and executing all unknown soldiers and officials.
Et à exécuter tous les soldats et
that no such policy existed.
Or, cela prouve qu'aucune politique de ce type
Mr. President, my third of the 6 points about to portray concerns pattern evidence.
Les preuves attestant de l'existence d'un schéma récurrent.
Yesterday, the co-prosecutors did not even attempt to contest our systematic demonstration that no such pattern existed.
Systématique montrant qu'il n'existait pas de schéma récurrent.
Mr. Rayner spoke very theatrically about the systematic nature of the pattern.
Du caractère systématique de ce schéma.
You might remember he asked the chamber 5 or 6 times, whether it was a coincidence, that killings occurred in exactly the same way across the country. And our question is this, Mr. President, is it a coincidence that the co-prosecutors failed to identify one single witness proving the existence of this pattern, which they say happened everywhere?
Qui se serait soi-disant
reproduit partout d'après l'accusation. Est-ce une coïncidence que les procureurs n'aient répondu à aucun des arguments
concrets que nous avons avancés durant notre plaidoirie?
Mr. Lysak also commented on the supposed pattern evidence. He told the chamber that the defense has,
and I quote, a thesis,
il a dit à la chambre, unquote,
la défense
about the supposed
avait,
execution of Lon-Nol soldiers in April 1975. He said our thesis was that executions happened in the southwest and northwest zone, but not elsewhere. In reality, Mr. President, we have no, quote, unquote, thesis about the execution of Lon-Nol soldiers. Our only thesis
notre
is that the co-prosecutors have failed manifestly and completely to establish the existence of a centrally directed policy.
De façon centrale.
The reasons for that conclusion
voici
are firstly that it is inconsistent with the direct evidence.
Une telle politique
secondly,
centralisée
that the so-called pattern evidence
directes,
is systematically unreliable.
And third, that the systematically unreliable evidence
is geographically concentrated in the southwest and northwest zone,
ces preuves
and
déjà
is therefore
non
irrelevant
se concentrent
to statewide policy.
Dans les zones sud-ouest et nord-ouest.
The prosecution contests none of these facts. In order to establish the existence of a policy based on unreliable evidence, not tested in open court, which is concentrated in only a small part of the country,
qui n'ont pas
the
été
prosecution
mis à
should be ready before this chamber with quite an extraordinary explanation.
L'accusation devrait être prête à fournir à la Chambre une explication bien
now, Mr. Lysak proposed a possible explanation. He suggested that maybe there were more Lon-Nol soldiers in the northwest and southwest zone than elsewhere in the country.
Qu'il se pourrait
yet at the same time, he does not offer the chamber even a shred of evidence in support of this proposition.
Et pourtant,
the evidence we showed the chamber last week demonstrated overwhelmingly that Lon-Nol soldiers were not executed in liberated zones prior to 1975. There's no reason to believe that Lon-Nol soldiers did not continue living in those zones until and after April 1975. Nor does the evidence merely show that fewer Lon-Nol soldiers and officials were killed in the special, central, north, the eastern and the northeastern zones in April 1975. It shows they were not killed in those zones at all. We have adduced substantial evidence affirmatively demonstrating that Lon-Nol officials who were present in the east zone or within the control of east zone troops were not harmed.
présents dans la zone est ou sous
like Mr. Rayner, Mr. Lysak failed to say anything about the evidence.
N'ont pas été
he
touchés.
Failed to give a single reason why the analysis we presented
Rayner,
to the chamber last week was erroneous. He failed to refer to a single statement of a single witness.
Justifiant son analyse des preuves que nous avons présentées la semaine
Mr.
dernière
President,
et
Mr. Lysak then suggested that
the
concentration of evidence in the southwest zone would be consistent with party center policy. Because Pol Pot had a close relationship to the southwest zone.
Le fait que des preuves soient concentrées dans la zone
it seems he would like this chamber to make two conclusions.
Correspond
he would like this chamber to conclude
à une
first
politique du centre that Tamok puisque Pol Pot
was close
était
to Pol Pot
de la zone
and
ouest.
Second that because Tamok was close to Pol Pot, everything that happened in the southwest zone
Tamok était proche de Pol Pot
reflected the intent of the party center.
Tout ce qui s'est produit dans la zone sud-ouest
but there is no
evidence
to support either claim.
Mais aucune preuve n'existe
pour neither claim has been the subject of so much as 5 minutes of witness testimony. Neither claim has been the subject of a single filing.
Ne serait-ce que 5 minutes de témoignage.
Before yesterday, neither claim had been the subject of 5 minutes
sujet.
Of debate before
avant
the chamber.
Hier,
and just last month, the co-prosecutor's position was that executions happened everywhere.
N'ont été consacrés à l'une ou l'autre de
Mr.
Ces
President, just last week, the co-prosecutor's position was that the executions happened everywhere in Cambodia.
Que les se sont
and 5 minutes before, Mr. Lysak took the floor.
Dernière, même, les que des
the co-prosecutor's position
partout.
Was that executions
cinq
took place
avant
everywhere.
Que Maître Lysak prenne la parole, les co-procureurs
never
que
did they try to link events in any particular
partout.
Part of the country with the party center. And they did not have to, because the position was that everything happened the same way everywhere.
Une région particulière du pays et le centre du parti. Pourquoi l'aurait-il fait?
It is critical to realize that Mr. Lysak's theory would be relevant to Nguyen-Chia's criminal liability only if Nguyen-Chia conspired with Tamok and was
Maître Lysak ne serait
but not with
pertinente
or
concernant la responsabilité pénale de
Nguyen-Chia.
Si Nguyen-Chia avait comploté avec Tamok et Rusnim, mais non avec Sao Pim et Naisaran, pour exécuter des
lots
soldats
of things
de
could be true.
C'est une théorie.
But the chamber,
cette
and that is the point, has never considered it.
Vrai.
The co-prosecutor
c'est possible,
never,
beaucoup de choses sont
before
possibles, mais la Chambre n'a jamais envisagé cette possibilité.
No
et jusqu'à hier, les co-procureurs
it.
Ne l'ont jamais affirmé.
And the chamber
aucune
has no
preuve
basis on which to make
pour étayer cette thèse, et la Chambre n'a donc aucune base pour
Mr. President, my fourth of the six
conclusion.
Points about Tulpo-Tre concerns the co-prosecutor's assertion that we failed even to address the core claim about
Tulpo-Tre.
They described their core claim as being that Nguyen-Chia participated in a joint criminal enterprise to execute class enemies and all those opposed to the CPK. In fact, we showed the chamber that at worst, the CPK categorized soldiers and officials along with other groups, such as monks and intellectuals, who were never, people who were never subject to a policy of
aux côtés d'autres groupes tels que
the co-prosecutor's position that the CPK viewed soldiers and officials with suspicion is insufficient as a matter of law to establish our client's criminal liability. The closing order alleges that at Tulpo-Tre, soldiers and officials were indiscriminately murdered en masse. And it follows that only a policy that required executions of soldiers and officials
en masse
is of any relevance to the chamber's deliberations.
Et donc,
abstract class theory without a clear link to a policy of systematic execution is plainly insufficient.
De soldats et de fonctionnaires en masse.
Mr. President, Your Honor, it's critical to recognize here that this difference between the CPK's general suspicion of Republican officials and its supposed decision to execute those officials summarily, that this difference is exactly the subject of Heng Samrin's statement to Ben Kiernan. Heng Samrin does not say that Nguyen-Chia never thought about former regime officials.
Et cette différence.
He does not say that those officials were not a subject of discussion.
Est exactement ce dont parle Heng Xiamlin dans
What he says is that when the party center decided how to deal with Republican officials,
ne dit pas they n'a quote, jamais pensé
I quote him, did not say kill. Instead, they said, and I quote him again, don't allow them to remain
n'ont pas
in
été
the framework,
de discussion. Ce qu'il dit, c'est que le centre du parti
Mr. President, this distinction got straight to the ambiguity at the heart of the co-prosecutor's allegation about the CPK's treatment of so-called opponents, which is that there is simply no evidence that such people were systematically executed.
Dans le cadre. C'est une distinction qui souligne l'ambiguïté des affirmations de l'accusation concernant le traitement réservé
that brings me, Mr.
PCK
President,
à ses
to my fifth point about Tu Potre,
il n'y a pas de preuve que les personnes
which
ont
is that the co-prosecutor submissions yesterday prove that they agree with us. Because while they claim their principal submission to be that soldiers were enemy of the party, they end up saying something much narrower and much simpler. They end up saying that there was a policy to kill, and I quote, officers of a certain rank and above. Now, of course, we dispute this. But the point is that the co-prosecutors know that the vague class theory Duyck claims to have read in the revolutionary flag was never intended to, and never did, translate to execution. Even they know that they cannot credibly claim that our client intended to execute soldiers and officials regardless of rank. And as we observed last week, the co-prosecutors failed even to assert that the alleged victims at Tu Potre were anything more than ordinary soldiers and civilians. Yesterday, they conceded that our client never intended to execute ordinary soldiers or civilians. Now, put together, these concessions established that Nguyen Chia never intended the execution of the alleged victims at Tu Potre. And this alone, Mr. President, requires the Chamber to acquit Nguyen Chia of all crimes charged in connection with Tu Potre.
Il est prouvé que Nguyen Chia n'avait jamais l'intention d'exécuter les prétendues victimes de Tu
Potre. My sixth and final point is that the co-prosecutors say nothing at all. Nothing at all about the possibility
that
any killings did take place at Tu Potre. They were constituted locally directed revenge killings.
Ont eu lieu à Tu Potre.
Let's not forget, Mr. President, the liberation of Pur Sat marked the end of a years-long bloody civil war. The alleged victims were supposedly the CPK's former opponents. Revenge killings under these circumstances are typical.
Les anciens opposants du PCK.
Your Honor, Mr. President, my very last comments today in this trial will concern the co-prosecutor's analysis yesterday of Rosnim's role in the CPK and the role of zone leaders more generally.
Now,
the critical point, and I cannot stress this enough, is that Rosnim was not a mere, quote, zone leader.
Que Rosnim
he himself was a member of the standing committee. He himself was, according to the co-prosecutors, reasoning an equal participant in the standing committee's practice of democratic centralism. Now, yesterday, the co-prosecutor said that Nguyen Chia met with Rosnim every 3 months in the Northwest Zone.
Au comité permanent.
And our question is, so what? What could the fact that Rosnim met Nguyen Chia possibly say about the content or nature of their relationship? The co-prosecutors tell us that at one of these meetings, Nim told Nguyen Chia about the execution of Nguyen Chia's uncle, Xu Heng.
Qu'est-ce que cela peut nous dire concernant la nature
now, Mr. President, we have trouble seeing their point. Nim did not ask our client for permission to kill Xu Heng. He was not, as the co-prosecutors observed, afraid to tell him he had executed Xu Heng. They asked why would Nim tell Nguyen Chia about Xu Heng and not about Tu Potre.
And
to us, Mr. President, the answer is obvious. Abdul Portray was none of Nunchia's concern. The death of his uncle quite obviously was.
La réponse est évidente.
Now, the hard evidence of the relationship amongst the various members of the standing committee, including those who were also zone leaders, is almost completely non-existent. As we saw last week, just about the only person able to speak with any authority is Ing Sary. And he says that within Ankar, and I quote, each zone was independent.
Ceux qui étaient chefs de zone kill as you please, do as you please. Comme nous l'avons vu la semaine dernière, la seule personne
Rosnim's flippant attitude towards Xiu's Heng's execution corroborates exactly that description.
Chaque zone était indépendante.
The best the co-prosecutors can find in response is a small handful of telegrams purporting to show Rosnim seeking advice or guidance from the party center. They do not mention the consistent testimony that communication from the party center to the zones was limited and mainly concerned goods requested by the zones. That Nunchia almost never sent telegrams to anybody.
Ces télégrammes ne mentionnent pas
and even this
le fait que les
very small selection of telegrams are all
le centre du parti
in 1977
et surtout des demandes
years
de provisions.
After Tupoutre.
Ce sont les témoignages qui le confirment. Nunchia n'envoyait pratiquement jamais de télégrammes à qui
que ce soit.
Même la petite sélection de télégrammes ont été envoyées en 77 et 78 des années après Tupoutre.
And I quote, gradually increasing. End of
des
quote.
Années où Ben Kiernan le confirme,
the only document
le
they showed you during a time period remotely relevant to these charges showed only that information was conveyed to the party center without any request for advice or instructions delivered to the zone.
Être pertinent, montre
the question is why is every other document the co-prosecutors presented from a period so far from April 1975? To paraphrase the co-prosecutors, we must ask, was that a coincidence?
D'aussi longtemps après avril
1975,
et pour reprendre la
there's only one hard reality about
Rosnim.
That reality is that he was ultimately purged.
Et c'est le fait qu'il a finalement été purgé.
The co-prosecutors tell the chamber that he was purged, but for them, the story ends there.
Et les co-procureurs nous le disent,
and for us,
mais pour
it
eux,
is just the beginning.
C'est la fin de l'histoire, mais pour nous, ce
the co-prosecutors do not take the next step and tell you why
Rosnim
was purged.
Plus loin pour vous expliquer
the answer is, Mr. President, he was considered a traitor.
La réponse, Monsieur le Président, est
he was considered a traitor because he was deliberately acting contrary to party policy.
Parce que
he deliberately imposed harsh conditions in the northwest zone for the purpose of destabilizing the party center. Mr. President, Your Honor, the co-prosecutors have never adequately answered a simple question. These are my last words. If Nunchia could so easily control Rosnim's behavior, why did they deem it necessary to use military force against him?
Pourquoi donc avoir besoin d'un recours à la force militaire à son égard?
The President. Thank you, Council.
Le Président. Merci,
the time is now appropriate for lunch adjournment. The chamber shall adjourn now and resume at 1:30 this afternoon.
Et nous reprendrons cet après-midi à 13h30.
Security guards are now instructed to bring Mr. Kyu Sampon to the holding cell downstairs
and
have him return to this courtroom this afternoon before 1:30. The court is now adjourned.
Some join Groucho.